más ya no tengo ingresos, teniendo una cabeza, quizá también Now it's three.
I cannot really hear your voice.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Okay, my microphone is. How about now? Is okay?
Yeah, much better.
Okay, so now we go to this text. Yesterday when 1.2, right? So now chapter 1, text 3. So here mostly this is just very short for now, because maybe I will explain some personality mentions. So we just read like yesterday. You can read. Is it big enough, right?
Yeah, big enough.
If not, I can make it bigger, actually. Really big. Yeah, I think it's better with me. Pasyaitam Pandu Putranam.
Pasyaitam Pandu Putranam.
Pasyaitam Pandu Putranam.
Pasyaitam Pandu Putranam.
Acharya Mahatim Chamum.
Acharya Mahatim Chamum.
Vyuthang Drupada Putrena.
Vyutam
Drupada Putrena.
Putrena.
Tava Shishyena Dhimata.
Tava Shishyena Dhimata.
Pasyaitam Pandu Putranam.
Pasyaitam Pandu Putranam.
Acharya Mahatim Chamum.
Acharya Mahatim Chamum.
Yudham Drupada Putrena.
Yudham Yudham Drupada
Putrena.
Putrena.
Tavasishena dhimata.
Tavasishena di dhimata.
Pasyaitam Pandu Putranam.
Pasyaitam Pandu Putranam.
Acharya Mahatim Chamum.
Acharya Mahatim Chamum.
Yudham Drupada Putrena.
Vyutam Drupada Putrena.
Tava Shishyena Dhimata.
Tava Shishyena Dhimata.
Okay, I want to adjust, wait 1 minute, adjust my phone. No, enter or not yet. The flower. Wait a minute. Hopefully it's entering now. Okay, so we can read now. Oh, you wanna try it? You wanna try first? So to read by yourself. Try. It's exercise.
Pasyaitam pandu pandu putranam.
Pasyaitam pandu. Okay, I will repeat. Pasyaitam pandu putranam.
Acharya Mahatim Chamum.
Acharya Mahatim Chamum.
Yudam Drupada Putrena.
Yudam Drupada Putrena.
Tavashishena. Di mata.
Tava shishena di mata. Pasya.
Pasya.
Behold.
Behold.
Etam.
This.
Panduputranam.
Panduputranam.
Of the sons of Pandu.
Of Pandu.
Acharya.
Oh, teacher.
Mahatim.
Mahatim. Great. Great.
Chamum,
Chamum,
military force. Vyudham,
Vyudham,
arrange. Drupada Putrena,
Drupada Putrena,
by the sons of Drupada.
Drupada.
Tava,
Tava, your
Shishyena,
Shishyena,
disciple means student. Di mata.
Di mata. Very intelligent.
Very intelligent. Yeah, translation and purport by His Divine Grace, Abhicharana Ravindu Bhaktivedanta Samusla Prabhupada. Translation. O my teacher, behold the great army of the sons of Pandu, so expertly arranged by your intelligent disciple, the sons of Drupada. Please hear it this. The translation.
Oh, my teacher, behold the great army of the sons of Pandu, so expertly arranged by your intelligent disciple, the son of Drupada.
Okay, purport. I will read this. Duryodhana, a great diplomat, wanted to find out the defects of Dronacharya, the great Brahmana commander-in-chief. Chief. Dronacharya had some political quarrel with King Drupada, the father of Draupadi, who was Arjuna's wife. As a result of this quarrel, Drupada performed a great sacrifice by which he received the benediction of having a son who would be able to kill Dronacharya. Dronacharya knew this perfectly well, and yet, as a liberal Brahmana, he did not hesitate to impart all his military secrets when the sons of Drupada, Dhritarjuna, was entrusted to him for military education. Now, on the battlefield of Kurukshetra, Dhritarjuna took the sides of the Pandavas, and it was he who arranged for their military phalanx. After having learned the art from Dronacharya, Duryodhana pointed out these mistakes of Dronacharya's so that he might be alert and uncompromising in the fighting. By this, he wanted to point out also that he should not be similarly lenient in battle against the Pandavas, who were also Dronacharya's affectionate students. Arjuna especially was his most affectionate and brilliant student. Duryodhana also warned that such leniency in the fight will lead to defeat. Pasyaitam pandu putranam acharya mahatim samam yudham drupada putrena tava shishena dhimata. O my teacher, behold the great army of the sons of Pandu, so expertly arranged by your intelligent disciple of Drupada. So Hare Krishna. So here It's mentioned that Duryodhana, you remember, right? Duryodhana is the son of Dhritarashtra. So he is a great diplomat. I mean, people who is able to make diplomat, like one who can, how to say, make consolidation or negotiating, or very expert in diplomacy. Yeah. And then here, you know, actually that Dronacharya is the commander of chief Senapati at that time. On the first day, actually. Dronacharya is the commander-in-chief. Dronacharya is also the teacher of both. The teacher of both sides. The teacher of Pandava and Kaurava, because when they are studying, they are actually family, one family,
okay,
like cousin brothers. So Dronacharya was a teacher for both sides.
Okay.
And actually, Dronacharya was having quarrel with Drupada, King Drupada. King Drupada is actually the father-in-law of Arjuna. This is father-in-law of Arjuna. So the quarrel was like this, actually. Dronacharya and King Drupada, when they are having education in the school, in ancient school, it's not like a big school like nowadays that everybody going from home and then spend some time in the school, in the building, and then meet the teacher there. And then after that, going back home. It's not like that. So in ancient time, the study mean going to the house of the teacher and stay there and become sah like that. And then they stay there, and then they also eat there. Everything they do there, like a boarding school.
Mm.
Maybe you know boarding school, right? So in ancient time, like that. Even a princess, they will need to go there. And they will serve their teacher over there.
Mm.
So it's only for men. For men who have that such kind of education. And education for the girl, it with the family. With the family.
Mm.
Education for the girl is with the family. So education in ancient time is for the boys, and they stay with the teacher. And they serving the teacher over there. Stay with them, eating there also. Everything is there. So in ancient time, it's like that. So Dronacharya is one of the teacher. He is teacher of military art. Yeah. So actually Dronacharya and King Drupada was actually like a study at the same, in the same place when they still boys, still small. So both of them, these two person, actually was a friend.
Okay.
They are a friend. And then Dronacharya is like a Brahman, Brahmana. Brahmana mean one who live very simple and usually not so rich. Brahmana usually they live very simple and then not so much accumulating wealth. They just live very simple. We can say maybe like like poor, we can say usually, but he is also very, very intelligent. So they both of, and Drupada was a prince, actually. He was a prince.
Mm.
And when they study together in one place, in one teacher, so they are like a friend. And one day Drupada actually saying that after I become king, I will share half of my kingdom to you. Like that. They was a boy. I mean, they not that time is not like serious thing. Because they were friends, so sometimes we saying something to a friend. So one time and then after they both of them finished the study. So both of them going back to their family and get married. And he become Drupada become king. And then Dronacharya, he also get married and have one son. And Dronacharya, because one time have a difficult, very difficult situation. He could not even feed his son. Because the son want to get milk actually, and then because of difficult. Usually Brahmana they live very simple and they will not work under anybody. Usually Brahmana they will satisfied with whatever they get by God arrangement. So his son is named Aswatthama. One time want to drink milk, and then because they don't have even capability to do that, so he give them, you know, when we cook rice, you know.
Oh, that. Yeah.
When we cook rice, sometimes there will be like a white
milky
thing like that. Yeah, something milky rice. Yeah, something like that. So he give him this. Oh, I drink milk. That he told him, and then it was his situation, and he was very. And actually, he asked help to King Drupada, already king that time. And then he come, and then he was actually coming to his palace, and then King Drupada was like, oh, it was my. And what he is saying also is something like rude, also very rude. King Drupada, oh, that's all what I said in the ancient is just like to say talking when we are still boy. So he is also very rude, and he mentioned that the friend means everybody who is equal, something like that. It was very rude. And after that, they have a quarrel, and then like this. So he was one to what is that? If somebody do something, and then we do something back, contract like revenge. He want to revenge, and Dronacharya actually come to Hastinapur. This is the kingdom where the Pandava and Kaurava actually. So Dronacharya going to Hastinapura, and because he is very learned, actually he is very poor, but he is very learned actually. In ancient time, when they teaching something, they just get from the student whatever they give. They live very simple. So somehow he come to the Hastinapur and become the teacher. Become the teacher for Pandava and Kaurava. So Pandava and Kaurava actually, Arjuna, Bhima, and all five brothers, they are learning military art from Dronacharya. And then also Kaurava, Duryodhana, and everybody also is become the student of Dronacharya. It's like it's a teacher for the royal. It's like a royal teacher. So he was teaching. And that time he also, you know, this Drupada actually already have a son. Have a son from fire sacrifice. His name is Drishtadyumna. And he sent his son to study military art from Dronacharya. Maybe in modern day might be difficult to describe. And King Drupada actually have this son, actually have a, no, I have to tell you the before that. So actually like this, King Drupada have sacrificed to get a son, and then his intention is to kill Dronacharya. Why? Because they have a quarrel. Before that, actually like this, Dronacharya, after completing the study, Dronacharya actually send the student, both Kaurava and Pandava, to catch King Drupada actually. To catch King Drupada, and Kaurava actually sent, and they fail. Kaurava fail. But when Arjuna come and Pandavas, they came and catch and defeated King Drupada actually. Because Arjuna is the most intelligent. The most intelligent. His arrows is very strong. He is very learned. So that's why Arjuna is the favorite student of Dronacharya. So after the after the finish of the study, the teacher asking, Dronacharya asked them, please defeat this king. So he sent Arjuna, and he defeated actually. But
how that king become father-in-law of Arjuna?
Yeah, there is a story again. I will tell you.
Because he will defeat him.
Yeah, already defeat, you know. It means that Arjuna is very strong. It's very strong. And then by this, he was so upset, right? Because he was defeated by Dronacharya. Because he teach somebody and then become very strong, and then attack them and successful. So he was very ashamed, right? Usually like that. King Drupada very ashamed and then want to take revenge. And to take revenge, actually he performed sacrifice, having son and daughter actually. And he performed like yagya, fire sacrifice like that. And then from that yagya appear two personalities, with this his daughter and his son. His son is Drishtadyumna. And he won actually. His intention is that the son will kill Dronacharya because he was ashamed. And when get born, it's not like from baby, like, but just directly appear like already adult, already big, not like us. We have to unite with husband and wife, unite, and then get from very baby like that. It's not like that. It was in ancient time, it is possible like that. Now it's not possible. So the appear two personalities. One is Drishtadyumna, it is the sun. And then another one is Drupadi. So in ancient time, usually the name of the daughter, they similar to the father or something. So Drupadi is the daughter. From that sacrifice appear Drupadi. So she is burned from fire. So he is very, what to say? but he is devotee of Krishna. Devotee of Krishna. He's very dear to Krishna. Because sometimes he was called Krishna, long A. Krishna. So he's very devotee.
She is the wife of Arjuna or no?
Yeah, yeah. So after that, because he was defeated and then feel ashamed. Oh, I have to take revenge. So he performing the sacrifice, and then appear two personality. One is the daughter Draupadi, later on become the wife of Arjuna, and then another one is Drishtadyumna, and he wanted that this son could be able to kill Dronacharya in ancient in the future. That is was his intention. And after that, King Drupada sent his son, Drishtadyumna, to study with Dronacharya. It's maybe like strange for nowadays. But because Dronacharya is a Brahmana. So whoever want to study with him, he is okay. He is accepting. If the student is qualified, so he will accept. So the Brahmana is like that. Whoever want to study, if he is qualified, I accept. There is no, like in modern days, if you, for example, in the modern school, if you cannot pay such and such, so you cannot enter that school. Although the children may be qualified, very smart or something like that, they will not accept. Because why? Because in modern days, it's mostly education is just a business, right? Even if a student, or maybe they give some scholarship, but in generally, it's not like that. But here, Dronacharya, because Dronacharya see that this person is qualified, okay. Although he know actually, this son of Draupada is actually intended to learn military art from him so that somehow can kill him for revenge. But Dronacharya is liberal. He is Brahmana. Whoever want to study with him, he is qualified, he accept. So Dronacharya accept the son of Drupada to study with him. So people that time, they performing duty very nicely. So in this way, Dronacharya accept him to study with him. And then actually, yeah, after to select the husband for Drupadi also, he said one thing. King Drupada actually invite all the Kshatriyas, all the prince from all over the world. So that the condition who can marry Draupadi is very difficult. Very difficult task. What was that? So the prince should be able to suit like something moving, like eyes, the eyes of the fish. The target is like eyes of the fish, but he should not look at the object directly. Should only see from the reflection in the water. That's very, very difficult. And somebody should. So in ancient time, they do like that. To select the husband for the Kshatriyas, for in the royal, usually they do different, very difficult tasks. Why? And to make sure that the person is very strong, qualified. Why? Because they are in the kingly order, in the royal family, they become Kshatriyas. They are Kshatriyas, so should be somebody very strong. Like if you remember Ramayana, another example.
Yeah.
In Ramayana example, Sita Devi was very strong also. Prihaning Siddha is very strong.
Yeah.
Why? Because actually he was when Janaka Maharaj performed, royal plowing ceremony in Cambodia.
Okay, yeah.
Royal plowing ceremony is taken from this tradition. So the father of Sita Devi, Grahaning Sita, is Janaka Maharaj. So when he performed the Bhumi Puja, we call Bhumi Puja, Boncerot Prehanangkal, Nakwal, is we call Bhumi Puja. So actually performed by Maharaj Janaka from ancient time. So when he was performing this, so the royal plow, Nangkol, is stuck with something. It's stuck with something. Oh, what is this? Why is stucking like that? So in the ceremony, and after he opened and dig in the soil, in the earth, so he found actually Sita Devi. Sita Devi is actually like the daughter of the Mother Earth. So Sita Devi was very strong. And there is a called the bow of Lord Shiva, we call Shiva Danu. It's very heavy. It's very heavy. Nobody can need many warrior or many people, many army to move. But one time, when she was still very small, she can actually what to say? Can move it? How wonderful! So this Maharaja Janaka was thinking, oh, this my daughter is very strong. So then he was thinking so. To select the husband for her should be somebody who can lift this and can broke it. after that time when Rama and Lakshman was in the forest, because he was asked by the one of the Brahmana, his name is Vishwamitra. Yeah, in ancient time, because Brahmana, when they have difficulties, they not directly counteract with them. There was a demon from Rahwana family that they always disturb the saintly person, the sage in the forest. Essay ke mien ke na kenong pray chon kalna mien ya dal bemplang ke reko is disturbing them from performing sacrifice. So actually they can counteract by mantras and different things. But because he is Brahmana, so he is not do like directly from himself. Actually he can do. But he will ask the kingly order. He asks from Dasaratha. Dasaratha is the father of Rama. Dasarath. Dasarath. King Dasaratha. So this Vishwamitra, King Vishwamitra came to the palace and asked, please let your son Rama and Lakshman to go to me to the forest to vanquish this demon, because it is the duty of Kshatriya. And Dasaratha said, oh, they're still young. How can they do that? And then somehow I will teach them. And and then Lord Rama and Lakshman go to the forest and then vanquish the demons. They were stitched by Vishwamitra. And after that, also he hear that, oh, now there is a announcement in Mithila. Mithila is the kingdom of Janaka Maharaj, the place of Sita Devi. So King Janaka announced that anybody who can broke or lift, actually not broke, actually to lift the bow of Lord Shiva, then he can become the husband of Sita Devi, like that. So this news also come to Rama and Lakshman and the teacher also. So all the prince actually come to that place. including actually Ravana also come, actually. Krongrib also come, actually. Mm. And that time, nobody could even move it. Nobody could even move it. So all the prince trying to move it. Not even 1 inch. And the last, actually, this was the turn for Rama, Lord Rama. Lord Rama, actually, Krishna himself appeared. It's actually, it's mentioned, he's also avatar, is coming from Krishna. So when his turn, he asked the blessing from the teacher, and then paying obeisances to the bow of Lord Shiva, and he leave it, and then, you know, put the string, and then it broke.
String.
No, string. You know, string is a ksai. Tenu na mean ksai man.
Oh yeah.
Da no okay. Da ksai tenu. Hai ba. So it's broken. So everybody was astonished. Oh, and then they say, all glories to Lord Rama, Ramachandra. So then the Sita Devi is given to Lord Ramachandra, and they get married. Yeah. So that is in ancient time how to select in royal family. Mm-hmm. Why? Mm-hmm. Because Sita Devi was very strong. She can move the bow of Lord Shiva, who actually need many army to move. So Lord Rama even can broke it. So in the same way like that. So Draupadi also, to select the husband, the father, King Draupada, put a very difficult task, very difficult condition. So one should be able to pierce or to shoot with the arrows to the target, but it's like eyes. It is moving, not staying, like always moving like that, but should not see the target directly, only see from the reflection from the water. So actually, why he set this condition? Because he know that only Arjuna and other personalities who can do that. So this is like a politic also.
Yeah. So but why Arjuna go to compete and want to become husband of
Draupadi? Actually, that time, they were in the forest. They were in the forest, actually. In the forest, and then they were in disguise, you know. They're in disguise. They are in disguise. I mean that they were banished to the forest for the first time. Mm. They was in the forest. And somehow, actually, it was not, they was considered already dead that time. Why? Because previously there was a very bad agenda to kill them. They was put in the one celebration of Deepavali, something like that. And they was put in one area, one like a palace, and they burned that. This is Duryodhana's. This is Duryodhana's plan to kill them, because he is very envy and he want to get the kingdom. It is actually rightfully the Pandavas' kingdom. Actually. So there was somehow or other, there is one the uncle who is actually the minister, is very good person. So he know this. He know this plan of Dhritarashtra and Duryodhana. So he sent somebody to dig, you know. They make a to say underground, they make a tunnel to dig, so that when this is burned, they actually can run away. So by that time, everybody already considered that Pandava already died, already burned in that house. Mm. But actually they escaped. They escaped. And then, yeah, it's already considered dead, all of them. And everybody was sad. And Duryodhana was very happy. Oh, now nobody else can, my plan is to get the kingdom. So, yeah. But then they go somewhere and then live in disguise. Nobody understand. Nobody know their identity. They just live like that. And then it was happening that time that King Drupada announcing everybody who can pierce this. But they were in disguise as a Brahmana. They were wearing like only white, very simple, or not like a prince or no. They were very simple. They live in the forest like that. After that tragedy of burning that house, the palace, everybody already considered them dead. And then after this announcement, Lord Krishna also there actually. Lord Krishna come just as a, how to say, to, because he is very dear to Draupadi. Yeah. Draupadi also is very devoted to Lord Krishna. Actually. He know that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So he also come actually there. Lord Krishna also come there. And actually, yeah. Somehow this Pandava also get this information, and then they also came. And that time there is one another actually, the eldest of Pandavas, you know, his name is Karna. He is very good also in shooting the arrows, and actually he can do that. He can do that. But why? Karna is like this actually. Karna is actually the eldest of Pandava. The mother is Kunti Devi. Yeah. Kunti Devi, before his marriage with King Pandu, or the father of Pandava, actually she got one son. Got one son, but it's not like because she, to say, she was indulged in the sexual activities with other people. No, because actually she got the mercy of one essay, so that he can chant the mantras to invite any demigods. To invite any demigod and will get blessing, and will give a son, like that. So she was, is it correct? Before her marriage, actually, is it correct this mantra really work or not? So she wanted to try that one time when she was not married to Pandu. And then, I want to try whether it's true or not. Yeah. This mantra working or not. If I invite any demigod, they will come and give me blessing. And then she actually chanted the mantra to invite Surya, Aditya, Surya, Pre-Surya. And then really come, she was astonished, so this mantra is working. Then I had to give blessing, Surya Dev said. And then there was a sun. Yeah. Just appear like that. There's a sun. And then, then she was astonished. So how now people will consider me? I have one son, and now I not even getting married yet. So how all this thing will make a bad news And then she actually bring this this son go to the river, and then put with many things, all the paraphernalia, and then is flown to the river, and then is found by one charioteer actually. Charioteer is considered as a sudra, a charioteer in Hastinapur. So he got this from, they found them and considered as their son. He was raised up by risen by this family. Yeah.
Mm.
And son of Ratha, Adiratha. Son of Adiratha. So he is considered to be like a son of a sudra, although he is actually very, very strong. Then he also come actually. His name is Karna. And actually he learned military art also. He's qualified. Because he is this son of a sun god. He's very bright, very strong. And somehow he was made a king actually. Duryodhana seeing his capacity. Yeah. Because actually before that there was a show. After the finishing study of both Kaurava and Pandava, there is like a, how to say, like competition between them just for show in the kingdom, so that everybody will see that the prince are very strong like that. So that time Arjuna can do the best, and actually Karna appeared that time, and then so Sutai, Arjuna just do like that. I can also do like that.
Okay.
And then, but it was not accepted because Karna was considered not a prince like that. That time, because of the son of a charioteer. And somehow, Karna is very, very, very envy of Arjuna actually, because who is actually the best how to say who can shoot arrows like that, how we call the
prone.
I forgot the English word for this. The anyhow, so Karna said, I can also do like that. It's just a simple thing. Because he is very strong, and somehow Duryodhana see this opportunity. So Duryodhana see the opportunity that this person is very strong, so I can use him for my purpose. So that is Duryodhana is very, you know, having a lot of tactic and different things. So he is a diplomat. He's very bad person, but he is very good in politics. So his intention is to declare him become a king. Mm. To declare, he was also quoting the verses from scripture that the people should consider to be such and such position or such and such a title by his qualities, not just by birth. And this is correct also. This is correct also. Actually, yeah, in Bhagavad Gita, I said the person should be considered a kshatriya, brahmana, or sudra, or a vaishya is according to quality and their work. It's not just by birth. That is correct. So he was also quoting this. But actually, he has bad intention. I will use this person for my purpose because he is very strong and very envy of Arjuna. So I will make him a friend.
Mm.
It is not true friendship, but because he actually want to make him as a, to use him actually. It's very strong. So I declare him become king of Anga. So Angga. Angga is the name of place of Hastinapur. So he was given a kingdom.
Kingdom to who?
Kingdom to Karna.
Oh my God.
The small, not a king, very big king, just a give some area and he will manage that area, you know. Like okay. Yeah, it's not a big king, but make him a king of Angga, Angaraj. So he was known as Angaraj. So the coronation is done that day also. And that time, Karna feel very indebted to Duryodhana. And I will do everything what he said. Because he has made me king and is now he is my friend. So Karna is thinking like that. So he was very loyal to Duryodhana, whatever. But he was very loyal. He's very good in loyalty. But actually, it's like a blind following him. Why? Because actually what the kingdom given to him, actually, the area that he managed is actually not belong to Duryodhana. So also because Karna could not think about this. Actually, the area that he managed, given to him, is not belong to Duryodhana, actually. So in this way, actually, Karna should understand also that actually Duryodhana is not giving what he have. It's not belong to him, actually. Right. So Karna also appear in that arena when Draupadi will select the husband. So he can actually can do that as well, actually. So many people try and they could not do. Many people try, they could not do. And then when Karna's time, Pandava is also already there, but in disguise of a Brahmana. And now Karna starting want to do that. And Draupadi said, stop. No. I will not accept the son of a charioteer to be my husband. So Karna was very, very angry also. Oh, this is insult to me. So in Mahabharata, everything is related, you know. So it is many related. So Karna was very furious. Oh, this is insult to me. Oh, wait, I will insult you in the future. Like he said, want to make revenge. So he was very furious, you know, because Draupadi say like that. I will not accept a son of a charioteer to be my husband. Although actually he can do that with the piercing the eyes. So but it is also the right for the princess to select. She will accept or not, this is also her right. Ultimately it's her right, because to select in the Kshatriya way of selecting husband is totally is up to the princess. Who she will accept or will not accept is her right. So in this way, Karna was very furious, and then everybody there was very angry. So Drupada, you have invited all of us here and make us ashamed. Because nobody can do that except Karna. But somehow Karna was not accepted by Drupadi, but she stopped it before he do that. Actually, she stopped it. No, I will not accept any the son of charioteer. So then, now Arjuna want to try. Arjuna was not known as Arjuna at that time because he's considered dead, already dead. But somehow his appearance is like a Brahmin. Wearing like white and only with the dhoti and very simple cloth, upper cloth. And then Lord Krishna know actually. Lord Krishna know that. And he was with Balaram that time also, and he was talking, how to say, talking lightly, like how to say, when we say something to somebody with that from the ear, just like very small sound. Well, how we?
A whisper.
Whispering, yeah, just whispering with Balaram. You know, my brother, that they are actually, that is Arjuna, and another four, they are Bhima, and so he mentioned, oh, so Lord Balaram know that. So then Arjuna tried and do that and successful, and everybody was very angry. Oh, King Drupada, you have insulted all the king here, that they cannot do, and you have, let's say, Karna, you don't accept what Karna will do, and then now you allow the Brahmana, to do that. It is insult for us all. And then that time also Karna want to attack this Brahmana, and then Arjuna very quickly took his arrows, and then before they attack, he already counteract with all his arrows already, attack all of them, not kill them, just the pierce of the bows of everyone bows. And then now, he was accepted as a brother and a mother, as a son-in-law of Drupada. Not that time, not yet that they are Arjuna actually. So then Draupadi was brought by him to his mother. To his mother. And then actually they live in the forest, because that time Pandava is considered already dead. Nobody know his identity yet. And after some time, Karna also thinking, who can do this? Only Lord Indra, Lord Shiva, Bhishma Deva, or myself can do this. So you are not Indra, you are not Bhishma Deva, you are not Lord Shiva. So you must be Arjuna. So actually, Karna no, because of he can defeat all this. So he can do very, very, very fast shooting arrows before even they start to attack them. So then there is something happened actually. When Arjuna and his brothers come to their hut in the forest, Mother Kunti, Mother Kunti come there, and then Arjuna said like this, Mother, now I have come, and I got an alm. Yeah, because they was living as a Brahmana in disguise, and they usually get the alm from people. So Arjuna said, Mother, now I have come with an alm. And what then alm, you know, when somebody begging like that, like a monk going to the house and then getting something, begging, alm, you know, alm, alm, alm.
But I think I understand what you want to say.
You understand, right?
Yeah.
So Mother Kunti said, okay, you divide among you. Without seeing actually, but actually Arjuna is bringing Drupadi home. Already he become his wife. And then distribute among you. And was they were surprised without Mother Kunti, without seeing, without seeing what they bring, actually is bringing Drupadi to go there. And then the mother said, distribute among you. So he was surprised. How can I do that? in ancient time, people are very truthful. So what they say, it's not like us. We can say something and then do something else. It's not like that. That time, people are very truthful. So the word of mother should not be false. So they was confused that time. And then the mother Kunti also surprised that, oh, why do you say that you are bringing alm? And now I have told you that to share among you. So how is, you should not say that it is alm. And I actually should not say without seeing first also. So it was a trouble. So people are very concerned about the truthfulness that time. So now how to solve this problem? And at the time, Lord Krishna actually appeared there. Lord Krishna appeared there. How to solve this problem? So Lord Krishna, advice is like this. So now it is because of the providence. It is already destined that Draupadi will become the wife of them. Yeah. Or the five brothers actually. But it's not like, it's in the process is like this. 1 year will be with one of the brother, and then the next maybe next year will be with like that. It's considered maybe very, very strange in modern day. And there is no such. You know polyandry, right?
Polyandry? No, I don't know.
Polyandry mean one lady have a lot of husband. So it's like this. But what Arjuna, Lord Krishna said there, because why? It's actually the desire of Drupadi. Drupadi desire that I have a husband who is very strong, who is very truthful, who is very strong, who is very intelligent, and who is very handsome. Nakula and Sahadeva is the handsome, the most handsome person. They are twin brother because they are actually like the son of Aswini and Kumara. Aswini Kumara, twin brothers. It's like a position for the heaven. So actually Drupadi has this desire. So now Lord Krishna appeared there and he revealed this. Drupadi, because you desire this, so now it is time that thing that is becoming true. So in this way, the word of Mother Kunti, the word of Mother Kunti not to be false, it means happening, and then it's also satisfying the desire of Drupadi. Yeah. But the system, although like that, it's not like every time. It's not like that. So first year will be with Yudhisthir, and then not with other brothers, and then maybe the next year will be with like that, so that they actually have five sons actually. From each of them, she got one son. So anyhow, the point here is that finally, Arjuna become the father and the son-in-law of Drupada. And then the news was spread all over, and oh, actually Pandava is still alive. And then all of them go back to Hastinapur. So that is If we see Mahabharata, there's a lot of things, a lot of teaching over there also, that people are very truthful that time. So the word is very valuable, not like nowadays. People can say anything and maybe
say. Nowadays, you say to, you are really straightforward or say something really true, then you will get, I don't know, but some country that you will get killed. You
say. Yeah. Yes, we can say like that. Yeah. So here, we can see from this that the son who would be able to kill Dronacharya. So this is Dhritarashtra. This is the brother of Drupadi. And he learned it from Dronacharya. And Dronacharya revealed all the military art to him. Yeah, all military art to him. That actually he actually knew that. But he is a Brahmana. He is performing his duty. Everybody who want to study with me and who is qualified, I will accept it, whether it is the son of my enemy or whoever. So people are doing duty that time. Not like now, oh, that is my enemy, I will not accept. It's not like that. He's performing his duty as a Brahman, a teacher. So he imparts all his military secrets to the son of Drupada. Whoever, whatever my ability, I will reveal to him, to this Rajuna. Nothing to hide. Yeah. Because King Drupada already gave him, and he is a Brahmana, a teacher, so he will not refuse. Why? Because he is qualified also. Because the study or education should be, the teacher should be qualified and the student also qualified. If both are qualified, then it can be going on.
Okay.
Yeah. The qualification for the teacher is also there in scripture, and the qualification of the student is also there. So there is three qualification for the student and is given in also in Bhagavad Gita. Tat vidhi pranipatena pariprasnena sevaya upadik santite gyanam gyanina tatva darshinah. So it's mentioned that one should be like surrender to the teacher. Yeah. Tat vidhi pranipatena pranipat means like pranipatena. It's like pranabat, something like that. So okay. It means that we hear from the teacher. Tat vidhi pranipatena pariprashnena. When he start to question, to have question. So that is also the science of intelligence. If people have question, then it's a sign of intelligence. So one, the student should be surrender to the teacher, and then following what the teaching of the teacher, and then tadvidi pranipatena pariprashna, and having question. Yeah, it's not just following but without questioning. If we have doubt, we have to ask the question. So that is the second one. And sevaya, also to serve spiritual master, to serve the guru. So in ancient time, the student will be living with the family of the teacher, and they do everything over there. Even Lord Krishna, when he was in his education, he went to the forest to collect the wood to cook. So it's like that. It is not slavery, but actually, you know, actually, it is easier for us to mold a children when he is still in young age. Yeah. When it's already grown up, will be difficult to teach them because they will not change. So there is, and Chanakya Pandit mentioned actually, that the son, up to 5 years, we have to consider as like a king. So whatever they want, we should give. But after that, 5 to 10, we have considered them like a slave. It's not torturing them, but it means that we have to teach them. If they have something wrong, we have to correct. Otherwise, the bad qualities will become more and more, increase. Yeah. So when that age, 5 to 10, we have to teach them. Yeah. And after 15, we have considered like this is how actually parent deal with the part with the children. So when they 15, we have to consider them like a friend. No more. Maybe we can advise something, but now already grown up and it's like considered as a friend like that when it's reaching 15, you know. But before that, we have to like educate them like a slave. Mm-hmm. It's not like torturing them or make harm to them, but it means that the point is that if they have bad qualities, that time we should correct. Otherwise, the bad qualities will increase. So in ancient time, the education is since very childhood. They are very young. And they live with the teacher and train over there. They live very simple and usually not mixed with a woman. Yeah, usually. Why? Because to have good qualities at that time, actually, from young age, they should have very strong like that, live very simple. Although they were a prince, all of them are king. I mean the son of the king, but they live very simple in the house of the teacher. Maybe if nowadays there is a prince, they live very opulent and spoiled, right?
Yeah.
They live very opulent and there is no education and then spoiled. Without education, although a person is a prince, if no education, and become spoiled. Yeah. So that was how actually Dronacharya acting. He was accepting everybody who is qualified to become his student. So this is very nice. Yeah, this is also about culture, you know.
Yeah.
This is about culture. So here in the battlefield of Kurukshetra, Dhritarashtra took the side of the Pandavas. Yeah, Dhritarashtra is the son of King Drupada. Somehow, they are like a brother-in-law of Pandavas. Dhritarashtra is a brother-in-law, and he is very expert in making arrangement for the army. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And he is who arranged the military funds after learn from Dronacharya. Mm-hmm. And Duryodhana in this is actually explained, pointed out the mistake of Dronacharya, so that you have teach all this military art to Dhritarashtra. So now he is a very political person. So Duryodhana is addressing his teacher that now you should not compromise again. Like you have made a mistake that you already teach him. Now you should not do the same. But actually it's also bad activities. Why? Because Duryodhana is actually a student of Dronacharya and he tried to say like that. It's not proper actually. Now this is he will do everything to achieve to get the kingdom actually. This is bad. Duryodhana is bad. But he is very tricky people. Tricky person.
Clever actually.
Yes, very clever. Clever in the in quote. It's very clever. So he is pointed out to his teacher that you should not make a mistake again. You have teach this Dhritarashtra all military art now you should fight without leniency, you know, leniency?
No.
Without affectionate, like lenience. Oh, it's okay. For example, if we have a child and then our child, oh, just make them very comfort, that not too hard to them. It's leniency. Duryodhana also warned that such leniency in the fight would lead to defeat. So this sloka is explaining about that. Tava shishena dimata. Pashaitam panduputranam acharya mahatim samam yudham dhupadaputrena tava shishena dimata. Oh, my teacher, behold the great army of the sons of Pandu, so expertly arranged by your intelligent disciple, the son of Drupada. So every word here has a meaning. Yeah, why he used this, the son of Drupada? Why? Because Drupada is the enemy of Dronacharya. Okay. I think it would be enough for today, right?
Yeah. You know, interesting story, because he it's just like kind of a sentence and
why? Because Bhagavad Gita is philosophical thing. Now we are not entering into that, because it is like setting before Lord Krishna saying this. Now is just preparing to that.
Yeah.
Because mostly will be philosophical and devotional things in Bhagavad Gita. And as we know that this is part of Mahabharata. So if we sometime have a time also to watch the movie, I will send you the link.
Yeah.
This is, you know, it is my favorite. When I was still grade 1 or 2, 92, that time there was no much television. Only few people have television.
Okay, and television?
Black and white, you know, still the black and white screen. And we go to their place to see this every week.
That's why I can feel that you really, the way how you talk to me, you really understand and remember everything.
Yeah, because we sing several times. We sing several times, and now in YouTube we can see, actually. So it is, you know, it's a very great, we call epos, you know, it's like a very nice story, and giving us also many kind of moral teaching as well.
Yeah.
And Bhagavad Gita is the essence of Mahabharata. Yeah. So we are here. So we cannot, separate just Bhagavad Gita, because it is like a integral part. And Bhagavad Gita is the essence, is the teaching of Lord Krishna.
Bharata.
Yeah, Bharata is, even nowadays, you know, India, they not call himself India, because Bharata is coming from Bharata. This, it was greater India actually. That time there is only one emperor, Yudhisthira Maharaj, only one emperor. Other king is small king, who pay tribute to the emperor. You know, there is emperor, there is a king, right?
Yeah.
Emperor is mean very big king. King who is having other king as their, how to say, this like, and what is a smaller king like that. So anyhow, thank you for today.
Thank you so much for today. It's really, you know, yes, a lot of knowledge. And
today might be at 7 if I could manage, because I have to go and back to hospital actually.
Just let me know if something changed, and I'm really okay actually.
Okay.
That you design. Okay, but don't forget, I really want to see that movie that you said you will send me the link.
Which one? About Haridas Thakur?
I don't know. You said you will send the link. I don't know what link you will send.
It's about the one who is teaching Hare Krishna Mahamantra and he was tortured. Because I sometimes forget something. This is Kali Yuga.
The oh, remember. Yeah. Say.
Yeah, yeah. I will find again that Haridas Thakur. Yeah, it's a very inspiring story about one Muslim who was chanting Hare Krishna Mahamantra and it's very strong and being tortured in the 20th. Yeah, I will see again. If you remember what kind of movies, please let me know because
you said about Mahabharata.
Mahabharata, yeah, this is okay. Yes. So the same thing what we are reading today, Mahabharata. I will find now. I don't know if there is an in Khmer or not.
Okay, if in English.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, so thank you, Hare Krishna. We'll see you again.
Thank you.
Yeah, Hare Krishna. Have a nice day.
Have a nice day.